How does the finishing process that you're able to do compare with an isotropic super finishing, and what are the advantages and disadvantages of each?
Yeah, isotropic finishing is more or less the alternative to super finishing, but it is a completely different technology. You need in your shop floor additional material handling because mm-hmm. you still need to grind these parts. Then you need the material handling to get it to this isotropic finishing machine, and you need to control this process. So it's another different process and additional material handling, additional knowledge to the operator running the shop, while super finishing on the grinding machine is just different tool, different software, and then you have it integrated off the machine. Of course, you also do not get super finishing on the grinding machine for free. It is additional cycle time, it is additional tool cost, but it is much more easier than to add another process. Plus, it is more stable because in a grinding machine, you keep the tool parameters, the grinding parameters constant, so you get a constant quality output, which is today still a big challenge for isotropic finishing.
Mm-hmm. Very good, thank you. I'd like to talk about the dressing process mm-hmm. and what improvements and changes have been made in the technology for that.
I think the biggest improvement in the dressing process today has been made towards terms of productivity. This is with relating to multi-rib dressing. Mm-hmm. If you look at a grinding worm, it has multiple threads. Typically, it has three or five threads. And in conventional dressing technology, you use the full-form dressing tool that is dressing one gap or one thread of the grinding worm, including the tip. Mm-hmm. And then you had to run through all these threads. That means for a three-threaded worm, three times, for a five-threaded worm, five times. And with a multi-rib dressing tool, you can do all these threads with one stroke. And this improves your dressing time by more than 50%, just to give you a value. With conventional dressing in serial production, you have a dressing time for a grinding worm with 280 millimeter in diameter and face widths of 160 millimeter of 4.5 minutes. And with multi-rib dressing, you can bring this down to 2 or 2.5 minutes dressing time. So this is a significant mm-hmm. Cycle time improvement in the dressing time, and also this brings down the total cycle time and the productivity of the process.
Very good. How will future demands in the automotive industry continue to change the gear grinding process in the coming years?
Yeah, it's a very visual question to the future, and to answer it, to give a global answer, is maybe from a tendency, the amount of gears in a transmission, especially in automotive, have come to a peak with 10-speed transmissions, dual clutch transmissions, mm-hmm. and the number of speed gears, pinions, sun gears that are involved. So we are pretty much on a peak, and the development and the market share is indeed going in the future a little bit more towards e-drives. Maybe not every car, but every second car that you have, or if you a few fancy cars on the road, there will be in 3 to 5 years a significant amount of e-drive cars sold. We see this at nearly all at our OEM customers. And the good thing is these e-drive or these e-cars still have gearboxes, but the number of gears will reduce. Mm-hmm. On the same time, the quality level will increase because these cars are, or these transmissions are, more noise sensitive. If you have a e-drive car, there's no combustion engine creating noise. It's a very silent and smooth ride. So you manufacturers have to make sure there's zero noise coming out of the gearbox. And the future is to respond on this with technologies to modify the gear in micro finish, in macro finish, in surface structure, to help finding solutions, getting the frequencies of the gear and the gearbox in harmony, not to create frequency peaks that come out as gear noise later, to find methods to install manufacturing processes that ensure quiet gears or not noise sensitive gears mm-hmm. go out there. This is one approach for the future. And the other one, I would like to take the big word Industry 4.0. It is more transparency in the process and an easier production process. Mm-hmm. That means more integration, more closed loop functions where you have the gear grinding machine connected to the inspection machine and you have an automatic correction in a closed loop. I was telling before we have now a series of Kapp-Niles metrology of inspection machines. This is also responding to this demand. We are responding to this demand on working on our HMIs, on our software, to get a much more user-friendly interface, to make it more working like smartphone technologies, so mm-hmm. people can intuitively work on this. We have it on the machine that we show on our booth with a new software. We call it Kapp-Niles Grind. And you have, when you look at the control, you can, it's like looking to the inside of the grinding machine. You can see the workpiece, you can see the grinding tool, the dressing tool, and you just click on if you want to modify dimensions. And this makes it easier. It makes it intuitive and just up to the current and new generation. As a second approach to the future. And the third thing is I would like to mention is intelligent tooling. What we are developing today is tooling with embedded RFID chips. That means you have it in the dressing tool, you have it in the flange of the grinding tool, and also in the work holding arbor. And every time you set up a new job, you have maybe just a chip card, or you just pull off the job from the network, and then you all the tools or the tooling you set up in the machine, you just scan with this RFID code, plug it in, and mm-hmm. the machine knows what is in. It has all the dimensions. It knows how many dressing cycles the tool has done, how many expansion cycles the clamping arbor has done, what is the current size of the dressable grinding tool. So you don't need to make so many inputs anymore. Everything is more intelligent, more embedded, and easier for the operator to run.
Mm-hmm. When will we start to see those in the field in application?
This specific technology we introduced the first time 2 months ago at IMO show in Hanover, and we have it in the first level and at selected customers in production, and we will roll it out and put more function to it in the close future, and we are able to deliver it with a regular lead time of new machines we sell on our more advanced mm-hmm. grinding machine series.
Sure. Very good. It's a very interesting discussion, and I want to thank you for your time. It's been a very informative.
Thank you, Randy.